Publishing changes from within view updates is not allowed. This will cause undefined behavior. If you're updating your SWIFTUI app to iOS 16 or SWIFTUI 4, then most probably you're going to run into this purple warning. It's a really annoying warning that nobody seems to know how to fix. Well, not anymore, because in this video I show you why this warning pops up and how you can fix it. Let's take a look at the code. And if you want me to fix other bugs inside your code outside of this one, go ahead and check out rebeloper.com/mentoring, where you can meet me on a 60-minute Zoom call. I can fix your bugs, I can talk about SWIFTUI, I can teach you SWIFTUI, or whatever you want me to talk about regarding iOS development. So go ahead and check out rebeloper.com/mentoring. So today we are going to talk about this ominous warning. It's a purple warning. Publishing changes from within view updates is not allowed. This will cause undefined behavior. And if you're updating from iOS 15 to iOS 16 or SWIFTUI 3 to SWIFTUI 4, then most probably, according to how your app is structured, your data flow is structured, you will get this warning. And it's quite annoying because, yeah, it says what it means, but you don't really know how to handle this. So today I'm going to show you an example of this and how to fix this. What I have done is created a sample project with a sample error here. And what we have here is just two views, a content view, which will present a detail view as a sheet. And that presentation is handled by the app service observable object. So let me tap on that button. If I tap on dismiss, you will see that immediately we have this publishing changes within view update. It's not allowed. This will cause undefined behavior. And also we get this purple warning right over here. There we go. And yeah, this might come up on the main or maybe on some line of your code, but basically it is the same thing. So what goes here? So what's going on? Well, basically with SWIFTUI 3 and SWIFTUI 4, the data handling kind of changed how SWIFTUI handles most specifically the published variable. And as you can see, let me just go through this project real quickly. Here we have an app service. It's an observable object, has a published variable. Okay, I'm just adding this published variable, creating it and adding it as an I'm creating the app service and adding it as an environment object on the content view. On the content view, grabbing the environment object right over here and having a button that triggers the is presented published variable. So we are toggling it from false to true. And that in turn is showing a sheet. As you can see, the is presented is bound to the sheet. And the detail view is actually the view that we are presenting. The detail view has the environment object again, app service. Also, we have the environment dismiss variable. So just to make a point that, okay, this is how you can also dismiss. But basically what we want here is whenever we toggle the is presented again, so we are setting it back to false, then the detail view should be dismissed. Again, let me just build and run so you can see what's going on. When I tap dismiss, I get this purple error. Okay, so what's going on? And by the way, if I just use the dismiss also, let's see, app service. If I use the dismiss right over here, it will do the same thing. So let me just build and run, detail view and dismiss. So this is a really strange kind of error. It's not an error, it's a warning, a purple warning. So what we have to learn is that published variables are handled differently in SWIFTUI 4. And yeah, this is what we are going to talk about. Basically, you should not bind published variables. And that's the bottom line. That is what's the new thing. You should not bind published variable. Where? Because when we are changing the published variables values, this is what we are going to get. We are binding our published variable right over here. And if you take a look at the sheet's description, how we should initialize the sheet, let's see, let me just go there. Well, it looks like it's not having that auto-completion for the documentation, but basically it is using not a published variable. How we are doing it right now, it's using a state variable. So let's fix that. Let's have a private state variable right over here. and let's name it is presented. By default it's to false. This is what you were basically thought about how to present sheets and with the state variable. So let's double check that we have dismiss right over here. Great, so we are not using the app service at all. We're just using the is presented. Now what we want to do is remove the buttons actions also to be using the state variable. So detail view, dismiss. And as you can see, no purple error. So that is kind of the solution for this. Do not use published variables with binded values. But this is not okay because then you will have a lot of is presented state variables. You will not be able to bind, but like deep link easily. Yeah, there are a lot of good reasons why we would use the is presented on the observable object. So how to fix this? Well, there's a workaround for this. It's a little bit complicated, but bear with me. I will show it to you, and then we're going to also create a little bit of a view modifier for that. So what we want to do, let me just have here a little bit more space. We want to, this is basically the end result. So we want to have app service is presented, so we want to trigger the published variable, and also right over here we want to trigger the published variable. Okay, that's great, but as we learned, we need to have a state variable for the binding. So what do we do? Well, we listen to the published variable and change the state variable's value. So for that, I'm going to have an on receive, so dot on receive, let's see our app service, and dollar is presented, there we go, and this is presented. Okay, and now I want to grab our is presented state variable and give it the value of our new value, the is presented. Okay, let's see how this looks like. Let's build and run. It succeeded, great. On the detail view, dismiss, and it's quite fine. It's okay, it's working. We have detail view, dismiss, really nice. But what if we wanted to use the dismiss right over here? So the environment object. Let's just build and run again. And let's see what happens right now. So I tap on detail view, dismiss, works okay. Tapping on detail view again, you see, nothing happened. If I tap again, it will do the sheet animation. Dismiss, tapping detail view again, nothing happens. Now it's this presenting it. So what really happens here is that we are listening basically to our, the presentation is done with the published variable. And we are triggering the presentation right over here, but we're not listening when it is dismissed with other ways of dismissing, being a slide down or being with the dismiss environment. So what we want to do is listen for those also. So what I'm going to do is have an on change of, and on the on change of is presented, I want to update also the published variable. So right over here under perform, let's just go is presented, and then I'm going to update our app services is presented equals is presented. Okay, let's see if now we have fixed our issues. Let's go tap on the detail view, dismiss, and now tapping again, well, it's doing what it should do. Let's do that again, detail view, dismiss, really, really great. But this is cumbersome, right? So we have our is presented state variable. We also have the app services is presented. Well, this is a must. So we have to agree that, okay, this is how it is. We do need to have a state variable with that. Also, because we do need to bind it to the sheet. What about this one? you don't really want to have these like two view modifiers over and over again for each state variable. So what we are going to do today is going to create a simple extension on the view that will be just a one-liner. So basically what we need to do is move this into a view modifier. Okay, let me just have an extension right over here of view, and let's just name this sync for example. So func sync, and we are going to sync the published variable. So the published. And we are going to need here a binding bool. You will see later on in just a second why that is. We are going to sync it with our binding, the state variable that we added to our view, binding, there we go. And this is also a binding bool. Okay, and it's going to return some view. And there we go. Let's just add in here self. Okay, so I know this is a little bit confusing for now, but bear with me. We are going to add these two in just a second. So let's start off with the on change, for example. So on change. And what do we want to add in here? Well, the published dot wrapped value. And right over here, we are going to get back a published. And we are going to change the bindings wrap value dot wrapped value equals to our newly grabbed new value, the published. So this is basically like this. These lines are representing these lines when the actual published variable is changed. Now let's take care of these lines also. So let me just have more space right over here. Again, an on change. And right over here, we are going to listen to the bindings wrapped value. And we are going to get back a binding. And right over here, we are going to have our published wrapped value equals to our binding. Okay, so yeah, go ahead and check it out again. This is how it should look like. Now we can just uncomment these. So all we have to do now is just use the newly created sync view modifier. Let's just have this sync, and it's not auto-completing, but I'm just going to type it out. So we are going to sync our $appService.isPresented. And please note that the dollar sign is before the app service and not before the isPresented. With $isPresented, that is the state variable that we declared previously. So let's build and run and see this in detail. There we go, detail view, dismiss, detail view. It's working as expected. One last check right over here. If we just go under detail view and use the actual isPresented toggle, let's see if that is going to work as well. Detail view, dismiss, detail view, dismiss. It's working as expected. Now, if you do like this fix and you do want to learn a little bit more about core data, go ahead and check it out. It's right over here.